Hi friend, welcome all to my educational channel Math A to Z. This is the first lecture on group theory. And to know all about group theory, subscribe my channel and share this. In the first lecture, here we define a group and give some important example of group. Before going to give the definition, we introduce a non-empty set G. Non-empty set G. This is not equal to phi. And let here G has two elements, A and B. Now define a binary composition on G, and the binary composition is sometimes denoted by star or circle or dot circle or simply dot or simply plus or plus circle, etc. Now what is binary composition? Binary composition star is a mapping which maps from G cross G to G. Okay, that is, if we find out G cross G, then it is AA, AB, BA and B. Okay, and the star is a mapping from this set to this set. Clearly, for any two element of G, the binary composition gives result which is must belongs to G. That is, A star A star B, B star A, B star B, all belongs to G. Okay, this is the binary composition defined on G. If we consider the non-empty set G together with the binary composition star or together with the binary composition circle, this system is called algebraic system. Or sometimes it is called algebraic structure. Now, this algebraic structure, G star or G circle, is said to be a group. Said to be a group if the following properties are satisfied by G star or G circle. Now the properties are, the first property, property 1, for all A B belongs to G, imply A star B belongs to G. And this is the closure property. And if it satisfies, then we say that G is closed under star. And the property 2, for all A, B, C belongs to G, imply A star B star C equal to A star B star C. This property is called associative property. Associative property. And the third property is there exists E belongs to G such that for all A belongs to G imply A star E or E star A both gives the result A. Okay, and this is called identity property. And clearly, since this is called identity property, so E is the identity element of the group G. Okay, identity element of this set or this group. And the last property of the group is for all A belongs to G, there exists A dash belongs to G. Such that A star A dash equal to A dash star A equal to E. For every A, there must exist A dash in G. Such that A together with A dash, this binary composition, and A dash together with A, this binary composition gives the result, the identity element. And this property is called inverse property. Inverse property. Okay. And if the algebraic structure G star or G circle gives four property or follow four property, then we know that G star is a group with respect to the binary operation or binary composition star. Here, these two properties, this and this, it is very important that here E operated from the right. So, this identity element is called right identity element. And this is operated from left. This is called left identity element. And if right identity and left identity are same, then it is called the identity element. Here we take E, the only element of this set. So E on the right and E on the left are the same. So this is the identity property. Similarly, for this, this is the right inverse and this is the left inverse. Now, together with these four relations, if the group G star satisfies the fifth property, for all A, B belongs to G, imply A star B equal to B star A, then this is the abelian property or commutative property. Commutative property. And then the group is called commutative group. Commutative group. And this property, that is the commutative property, first introduced by the Norwegian mathematician N. Abel. And to honor the mathematician, this group is also called Abelian group. Okay, so if together with this four property, if the five property be also hold, then the group is called commutative group or Abelian group. Right? And this is the definition of group. Now, we give some important example of group together with the explanation why this set is forms a group. The set Z plus the set of integer together with respect to the ordinary addition or usual addition. The set Z is 0, here right side 1, 2, 3 to infinity, and left side minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 to minus infinity. Okay, we know all that any addition of any two integer is also an integer. So the first property, that is closure hold. And if we add a plus b first, then we add c, and if we add b plus c first, then we add a, and these two results are same in the set of integer. So it satisfies associative property. In third, 0 belongs to Z, and we know that for all A belongs to Z, 0 plus A must be equal to A, and this is equal to A plus 0. So 0 be the identity element. Okay. Also, for all A, that is, if we consider minus 3, then there exists 3, such that minus 3 plus 3 equal to 0. Similarly, for all A belongs to Z, there exists minus A belongs to Z, such that A plus minus A equal to 0. And the fifth property, we know that for all AB belongs to Z, A plus B and B plus A are same. So this satisfies the commutative property. And we say that Z plus is an abelian group. With respect to plus, if we consider the set of matrix M2R, set of matrix formed with the real number, and this is 2 because we consider all 2 cross 2 matrix of real number, and the composition is usual matrix addition. Similar manner, we see that this is also a group and it is also an abelian group because the addition of matrix is abelian. Okay, but if we consider M2R together with the matrix multiplication, then we know that the multiplication of 2 cross 2 matrix is also a 2 cross 2 matrix. 2 cross 2 matrix. Here. Okay. So, we see that this is closed. That is the first property hold. And multiplication of matrix is also associative. We know all it. So, this is hold associative property. And we know that the element 1001, this is the identity element, it is named as I2, this is belongs to M2R. Okay, and for all matrix A into I2 equal to I2 into A, so I2 is the identity element, so third property also be hold. But if we check the fourth property, that is the inverse property, we know that if any matrix A, we can try to find A inverse, then it must be determinant A not equal to 0, that is non-singular. So the inverse of all the element of M to R is not exist. So this is not a group. Now if we consider all the non-singular element of M to R, all the non-singular element, and this is denoted by GL2R, and this is called general linear group, general linear group of real number of 2 plus 2 matrix. This is denoted by GL2R. Then all the three property together with the inverse property is also satisfied, because here we take all the non-singular element. Okay, so GL2R is a group since it satisfies all the four properties of the group. But here, if we try to find the commutative property, then we know that the commutative property, that is the fifth property, is not hold for matrix multiplication. So it is non-abelian group. Similarly, if we take GLNR, general linear group of real number of n cross n matrix, is also a non-abelian group. Okay, and this is the today's class. And lastly, we say that in some famous book, the definition of group theory has only three property, the property 2, property 3 and property 4, that is associative, that is identity, that is inverse. And here the first property closure is omitted, because when we consider an algebraic structure G star, then this algebraic structure itself a closure property. Okay, so if in some book the property 3, 2, 3 and 4, then this definition is also correct. Okay, thank you for watching.